In rapid growth of algae in ponds, if applied properly. This is because the nutrients go into solution more quickly, making them more rapidly available to the algae. Also, smaller applications of liquid fertilizers can be used, which may reduce the cost of pond fertilization. Any grade of liquid fertilizer can be used, as long as approximately 4 pounds of phosphorus are applied per acre per application. Liquid fertilizer is heavier than water. And since you want the fertilizer to mix with the water and not sink to the bottom, you need to use care in application. Another method of application is to pour the liquid fertilizer into a large container or tub at the pond's edge. Dilute it with 10 parts of water to each part of fertilizer, then slosh or spray the mixture onto the pond surface. You can also pour the liquid fertilizer and water mixture directly into the turbulence caused by an outboard motor. Pour it in near the prop. Or you can use the outboard motor's prop to create a suction through a venturi. Route a hose from the liquid fertilizer-filled bucket inside the boat down to the underwater prop. The action of the prop creates a vacuum that literally pulls the fertilizer through the hose into the water. Granular fertilizers also work well at recommended rates, but have a different set of application rules. When using granular fertilizer, you want to avoid direct contact between the fertilizer and the pond mud, because phosphorus in the fertilizer becomes trapped in the mud, which means it isn't available to the algae. A fertilizer platform positioned 1 foot underwater can be used to hold granular fertilizer off the bottom. You can either place open bags on the platform or pour the fertilizer onto it. The granules will slowly dissolve and water currents will distribute the fertilizer. A platform measuring 45 square feet is adequate for up to a 10-acre pond. Smaller platforms can be used in smaller ponds, and more than one platform should be used in ponds larger than 15 acres. As a rule of thumb, make your first application of fertilizer in late February or early March. Follow with 2 additional applications at 2-week intervals. Then make 3 more applications at 3 to 5 week intervals. If spring rains cause excessive water flow through the pond, it may be best not to fertilize until the rainy season is over. Continue applications at monthly intervals or whenever the water clears enough that a white disc called a secchi disc attached to a yardstick is visible to a depth of 18 to 24 inches. Suspend fertilization by the last week in October. Remember, this is only a guideline because pond conditions vary, needs vary. You may need to modify standard fertilization schedules and recommended rates for your particular size and type pond. Over-fertilization may lead to an oxygen depletion. Once you establish a fertilization schedule, you need to stick to it year after year. Stop fertilizing and the fish starve, because an unfertilized pond simply can't produce enough food to feed the number of fish living in a pond that was previously fertilized. Now, what if you fertilize and your pond still doesn't turn green or doesn't stay green for more than a few days? It may be that your pond water is too soft and your bottom mud is too acidic. If you don't get an algae bloom after 6 to 8 weeks of proper fertilization, you may need to apply lime in order to reduce acidity. Lime increases fish production in ponds with acid bottom mud and soft water, just as it increases crop yields from acid soils, because it makes phosphorus and fertilizer available to the algae. Phosphorus promotes the growth of algae, which, as we said earlier, are the base of natural fish food production in ponds. You can quickly determine whether your pond needs liming with a simple water testing kit available from fish farming supply houses. The kit measures total alkalinity and shows whether a lime application is needed. The number to watch for is 20 parts per million total alkalinity. Anything less than this indicates a need to add lime. Generally, the farther the water is below 20 parts per million total alkalinity, the better the pond will respond to lime application. It's a good idea to test your pond's alkalinity before fertilizer application. That way, you won't be wasting your time applying fertilizer when you need lime for the fertilizer to work. While the test kit can tell you whether your pond needs lime, it cannot tell you how much lime to add. That information is provided through a chemical analysis of the bottom mud. You can take soil samples in a full pond by using a boat and a sampler made by attaching a can to the end of a long pole. Of course, it's easier to collect a mud sample from a dry pond. In each case, you simply take samples along an S-shaped pattern over the entire length and width of the pond. Take 3 to 6 samples per acre from ponds more than 5 acres, and at least 10 samples from small ponds. Samples should be about the same size. If your sample is dry, thoroughly mix all the individual samples together in a container. If the mud is damp, spread it onto a smooth surface so it can dry. After the combined sample dries, gently pulverize it and place some in a soil testing box. You can get this box, as well as a special soil information sheet, from your county extension agent. Be sure to clearly write fish pond on the soil information sheet and soil box. Then take it to your county extension office or send it to this address. Soil Testing Laboratory, Auburn University, Alabama, 36849. For a small fee, the soil testing lab will analyze your sample and give you a detailed lime recommendation. New ponds can be limed before they are filled. Spread the needed amount of agricultural limestone evenly over the dry pond bottom. In ponds that already contain water, best results usually come from applying lime across the water surface. This can be done in small ponds by spreading bagged limestone from a boat. In larger ponds where several tons of lime are required, a platform can be built on the front of a large boat, between two boats lashed together, or from a pontoon boat. Bulk limestone can be loaded on the platform and distributed across the pond surface with a shovel or washed off the platform with a water pump. Take care not to overload the boat or it may capsize. Although the best time to apply limestone is during late fall and winter when fertilization has been stopped, you can lime acid ponds anytime if it's deemed necessary. Liming in the fall gives lime a chance to react with the acid bottom muds before the spring application of fertilizer. Another benefit of lime is that it helps to settle muddy ponds. If your pond stays muddy all the time, it's a good bet that it needs to be limed. Most ponds in acid soils with moderate water outflow will probably need lime every 3 years. One method that usually works well is to apply whatever total initial lime application the soil testing laboratory report calls for, and then apply one-third of that amount during each following year. This ensures that the lime requirement is always satisfied. Remember our earlier tidbit about weed control? Proper fertilization leads to good algae blooms, which block sunlight reaching the bottom, which prevents water weeds. No sunlight, no weeds, right? Well, hopefully, yes. But realistically, most ponds are going to have some weeds. While a good growth of algae is your first line of defense, this fellow could be your backup. He's the grass carp. The grass carp, or white ammer, is from China, but he has a decided appetite for Alabama water weeds. While the grass carp likes soft-stemmed submerged weeds best, he'll eat filamentous algae or pond moss, too. The grass carp can also control floating duckweeds, and when properly stocked at recommended rates, grass carp do not